Hey guys, welcome to Pursuit Kids Online. I'm so excited you're joining us today. My name is Miss Carrie, and we get to do my most favorite thing every single week. We get to worship. So get ready to stand to your feet, get ready to lift your hands and dance with us, because worship starts now.
From the beginning, you knew how far away we'd run from you. You're so forgiving. You planned a way to bring us back to you. There's nothing greater, no, than the love our Savior showed. We want to spread your
I thank you for what you've done. so I ask why. I can never forget what you sacrificed. Lord, I thank you for what you've done. And I can lose with you who I've won. No, I can't compare to none. Yes, I thank you for what you've done.
Hey guys, today in Pre-K, we're gonna talk about how Ruth found favor with Boaz. So get ready, because your video starts now.
It's Kelly!
Hey!
What are we gonna do today? We're gonna learn and play.
Okay.
Sing a song and pray.
That's right.
God really loves us. God really, really cares about you, me, our families.
That's right.
God's always right there.
I'm a superhero! I protect and defend all people and only ask for a little snack in return. I love cookies! Oh yeah, I protect and defend cookies. All people and cookies.
What you doing?
Just imagining. I'm wondering what it would be like to be a superhero and have superpowers.
Sweet acorns! Well, in that case...
Oh, I'm Super Cali. Who are you?
I'm your sidekick. Champion Chip!
Super Cali and Champion Chip! Protector of all people! Oh, and cookies!
And acorns!
Yes! People, cookies, and acorns! Hey, we need to decide what superpowers we have.
Oh, yeah!
I know! I'll have the superpower of flight! That means I can fly!
Oh, and I have the superpower of controlling the weather! That way, if it's cloudy while you're flying, I can just push the clouds aside.
I like that.
Ooh, I'll have the superpower of invisibility. That means no one will ever be able to see me.
Yeah, and I'll have the superpower of super voice. So I can be like, look out for my invisible friend. Invisible friend coming through. That way you won't bump into anyone.
I like that.
Oh, and I'll have the superpower of being able to make anything into food.
Yeah.
Doorknob? Nope. Cookie? Pillow? Nope. Pile of marshmallows. Handful of marbles? Nope. Handful of acorns.
Yum! And I'll have the superpower of super cheeks, where I can put all the food you make into my cheeks for safe storage. I kind of already have that.
Yeah. I was just wondering. All of our superpowers go together.
Yeah, that's true.
In this imaginary world where we are both superheroes, we really would need each other.
Yeah, we really would. It's like how you and I are good friends in real life. What's another word for a friend that you can trust?
Let's keep wondering about this while we check out our Bible story.
Today's Bible story comes from Ruth chapter 1. Long ago, there lived a woman named Naomi. Naomi and her husband had two sons. They lived in a city called Bethlehem. One year, there was not enough food for everyone to eat in Bethlehem, so they moved to a different country to find food. It was a very hard time. While living in the new country, Naomi's husband and both of her sons died. Now it was just her and the wives of her two sons, Ruth and Orpah. During her sadness, Naomi heard some good news. God had provided food for people living in her hometown, so Naomi wanted to go back to Bethlehem. Ruth and Orpah wanted to go to Bethlehem with Naomi, but Naomi told Ruth and Orpah to stay in their home country. At first, Ruth and Orpah both wanted to go with Naomi, but Naomi wanted them to be able to start a new family, which would be easier if they did so if they stayed there. Orpah decided to stay, but Ruth chose to go with Naomi. Ruth told Naomi that she would go wherever Naomi goes. Naomi's people would be her people, and Naomi's God will be her God. With that, Ruth went with Naomi back to Bethlehem. Naomi thought it would be okay to go alone, but God gave Naomi a companion. Ruth was there for Naomi, and God provides people to be with us too. When we feel alone, we can remember this truth. God gives us companions.
That's the word we were looking for, companion.
What's a companion?
I think that's someone who stays by your side no matter what. Just like Ruth did with Naomi. Just like how we always stick together in real life.
Yeah, can you imagine if you could fly, but you didn't have me to push the clouds aside?
Can you imagine if you were invisible, but you just kept bumping into everyone?
Can you imagine making all that food out of stuff, then having no cheeks to keep it in?
I really can't! And all this imagining and wondering, I can't imagine doing it without you.
Yeah, it wouldn't be nearly as fun.
So I guess in our imaginations and in real life, we really need companions. Friends we can trust. God gives us companions.
Chip and Callie.
Did you hear that?
Yes! It's the Super Callie and Champion Chip signal.
There must be citizens in trouble.
Yes, in need of a companion to save them.
Snack time.
Or there's some crackers in need of munching.
Well, I'm glad we could munch together.
Me too. Are you glad to have the companions God gives you? I am. I might need those super cheeks, Champion Chip. My dad serves up a lot of crackers.
Champion Chip, to the rescue!
Thanks for learning and growing with me, friends. Peace out!
Hey guys, today in elementary, we're going to talk about how God gives us opportunities. So get ready, because your video starts now.
It's Grow TV, where we grow together and learn about God.
Oh, hello, friends. To you, this may seem like a regular blanket, and you might ask, Steve, bro, why are you ironing this blanket? Well, let me ask you this. Remember when you were small, and any regular old blanket could be so much more? All you had to do was wrap it around your neck and tie it like this. I'm not Steve anymore.
I'm Super Steve, a hero with a freshly ironed cape.
Cool cape! No wrinkles at all.
Thanks.
Impressive.
Thanks. That's what I was going for.
Heroes with capes are great, but what would those heroes really be without their sidekicks? Which brings to my mind a game called Sidekicking It. So here's how you play. I'm gonna describe a famous sidekick, and you try to name the famous sidekick based upon my description. Ready to play?
I think so.
Okay, so the first sidekick is what's known as a Wookiee. He may look like a hairy monster, but don't be fooled. He's a skilled pilot of the Millennium Falcon and has helped Han Solo out of many tight spots. Name that sidekick.
Chewbacca.
Nailed it. Next one. These sidekicks are little and yellow, and they might cause quite a bit of mischief while trying to help Gru accomplish dastardly deeds. But their undying loyalty always wins him over. Name those sidekicks.
That's easy, the minions. Gru's not really a hero. He's more like an anti-hero.
Oh, what's that? Oh, okay. Our judges ask that you please not question the sidekick selected and just play the game, okay?
What judges? Why are you even wearing an earpiece and who are you talking to?
Great. Back to sidekicking it. Okay, last one. This sidekick is a little snowman. Because one of the heroes that he backs up loves him so much, she gave him his own personal flurry. So he never melts. He's always ready to offer Anna or Elsa a warm hug when they feel frozen. Name that sidekick.
Come on, of course it's Olaf!
Well, thanks for playing Sidekicking It.
That was fun. This game and having a cape really made me think. Being a hero is great and all, but a hero really isn't much of a hero at all without the people to come alongside them when they need it.
I guess you're right. Even superheroes can't go it alone. They need sidekicks or companions who stick by them through everything. And not just superheroes, there are a lot of stories in that Bible that show people working together too. One of them is the story of Ruth and Naomi. It's from the book of Ruth, chapter 1. Naomi and her husband had two sons. They lived in a city called Bethlehem. One year, there was not enough food for everyone in Bethlehem, so they had to move to a different country to find food. It was a hard time. While living in the new country, Naomi's husband and their two sons died. Now all she had left were her two sons' wives, Ruth and Orpah.
Wow, that was rough. She must have felt so sad and alone.
Right, but she wasn't alone. Actually, during this hard time, Naomi received some good news.
Thank goodness, what was it?
Well, there was plenty of food for the people in Naomi's hometown of Bethlehem now. She wanted to go back there. Ruth and Orpah were determined to go with her, but Naomi said no.
Why?
She thought that Ruth and Orpah should go and find other husbands to start new lives without her. But Orpah decided to do so, but Ruth refused. She would not leave Naomi's side, no matter what.
Serious side-kicking energy.
Yes. Ruth said to Naomi in Ruth 1, 16 and 17, "Don't urge me to leave you or to turn my back from you. Where you go, I will go, and where you stay, I will stay. Your people will be my people and your God my God. Where you die, and there I will be buried. May the Lord deal with me, be it ever so severely, even if death separates you and me."
I guess that was it, right?
Right. With that, Ruth went with Naomi back to Bethlehem. Naomi knew it would be hard, but she was set to travel alone. But God gave Naomi a companion. A companion is someone who comes alongside you. And Ruth was there for Naomi. And God provides people to be with us too. When we're in the midst of a hard time and feel alone, remember, God gives us companions. What are you doing?
I'm taking this off. I thought superheroes were cool, but sidekicks are where it's at.
Sidekicks wear capes too.
Oh. Okay. What else can I do to be sidekicking it? Oh. Give me a second.
Whoa. Thanks.
No problem. I'm your sidekick. Anything you need, I got you.
Cool. I could actually do with a glass of water. Like now.
Oh, sorry.
Often the times when we're going through something hard are the times we feel most alone. You might be going through something hard right now. If you are, don't forget to look around you. Just like God gave Ruth to Naomi, God places people around us to help us through, but we have to be willing to accept their help.
Here you go.
Thanks.
I remember when my family moved, I had to go to a new school. I had to make all new friends. I felt so alone, but I had my brother with me, and with him, I got through it. I'm sure glad that God gives us companions.
Maybe you can take a moment to look back and say, thanks to God for the companions God's given you.
Or look around and see how you can be sidekicking it for someone who's been going through something hard. It's been fun naming sidekicks and learning Bible stuff with you today. It's always good to learn and grow together. See you next time. Bye.
Hey guys, I hope you had so much fun worshiping with us and that you learned something new from your Bible stories. Don't forget to like and subscribe so you don't miss any updates here from Pursuit Kids. We love you guys and we'll see you next week. Bye guys.